Hi everybody, it's Sean here, and I'm a 20-year smoker no more. I'm pretty happy, thanks to e-cigs. This video here, first part of it that I'd like to hit on is, of course, the x-rays that I did promise everybody out there. They are coming along. Good news is, of course, well, I'm feeling pretty good, so I'm very hopeful that nothing negative gets found there. The originals I did get in, which is great news. Having a little bit of difficulty actually getting a new x-ray done. X-rays obviously are performed when you have problems with your chest. When you start calling around saying, hi, I'd like to get my chest x-rayed because of ecigs, it kind of goes off from there. So give me a little bit of time, but I will be uploading the x-ray results pretty soon. Keep your fingers crossed, as I will. The next part of this video is a little bit of a one-off. This is more for newcomers, so if you're somebody who's been using ecigs a long time, this video might not be too helpful for you. This is a compilation of just really weird things that have been asked by me quite a few times, and YouTube video people out there who said, hey Sean, can you make a video about that? So I'm going to. These are really just tidbits, very specific on the 510 model and some of the things that people have found, not necessarily myself, and they've passed that information on. I'm going to pass it on to you right now. One of the very first things I'd like to bring up, it's commonly asked to me, of course, is as far as your cartridge falling out of place. These units here, you'll have them in your mouth or whatever, and all of a sudden, boom, the whole piece falls out, and there's no gription there on the cartridge itself. There's actually a pretty easy fix to that, and that fix is sandpaper. You just put a little bit of grit on the plastic that you see that I'm doing right here, and you get yourself a little bit of a grit, so then you have a little bit of gription, and that fits pretty well. Cartridges can really be refilled over and over again for quite a long time. I know some people are even putting their own polyfill in there, whatever it might be. And one of the failures that they finally come up with the cartridge finally dying on them, is it just doesn't grip anymore. Even right now, just me doing a little bit of that, it's really gripping a lot harder. So that's a good thing. That is one of the things just for you guys to know. Now, if you're out there, maybe you're at a restaurant or whatever, and it keeps on falling out, it's annoying you, there is a very quick fix that I found really early on. You use the steel portion of the atomizer, and what you actually do is one of the little pieces of the cartridge there, you push the plastic out, just like that. And that will cause the plastic to come out a little bit more, and that will kind of fill that gap. So that's kind of a neat thing that you can do with that. So there you have with that question. Now, another one that has come up quite often is 90% of these 510s that are shipped out there, they are shipped like this. And right now this looks like a regular cartridge and an atomizer. Well, the thing is, the cartridge that is on an atomizer when it's shipped, it's a blank, it's a dud. It's a dummy. There's no polyfill in there. A lot of very first-time users will get one of these, and they will smoke on it, and they're like, hey, I'm not getting any vapor. This product is terrible. That's because you didn't put a pre-filled cartridge on there, or you didn't fill it up. So again, the cartridges that come on these are usually dummies. Now, I technically don't throw these out. These are very useful for me. Over time now, I quite enjoy what's called the direct drip method, and that is when you use a empty cartridge like this and you don't use the polyfill. One of the things is topping off the cartridges, I've learned a lot of us have, is the thing you want to do. You get the best vapor output, you get the best flavor, everything like that. So I drip directly onto the atomizer. As far as I'm aware, as long as you keep away from a lot of the sugar-based e-liquids, not a lot of harm there as far as your atomizer goes. On a personal level, I've seen no harm on my atomizers, and as all of you know, I've been doing this quite a long time. And what I do is I put 2 to 3 drips in there right before I'm going to use it. Don't drip in there and just put it to the side, because it can drip down there. So I drip it right in there, and then I inhale, and it lasts about as long as what a normal cigarette would be. So that's kind of a nice thing that I do have there. Another one, this goes out to the ladies out there. Could be some guys who are very badly manicured too there. This has to do with the battery and the button that you see right there. And this is a common thing. I had a few people who wrote in to me on the YouTube comments as far as that was, and they said, you know what, I had batteries that were going out on me. What it was the light would go on and it would stay on the entire time, and it took a little bit of time to figure out what was really going on. Why I say this is mainly out to the ladies has to do with long fingernails. Atypically, you just push down on this button and when you're pushing down on a button, it works just normally. Some of the ladies, what they will do is they will take their fingernail and they will gouge it kind of in there, and they're pushing the button side to side rather than downward. It will still activate the battery, but what it's doing is it's tearing up this rubberized button that you have, and it can force the button, part of the rubber, right into the battery and leave the battery on. And then when the battery's on, the atomizer overheats and everything like that. So that's another tip that was actually sent out to me there. Another thing, of course, is I had comments of people asking me with the polyfill, they would open up the cartridge and the polyfill would be stuck on the atomizer and not in the cartridge. This is a very simple reason. You didn't have enough liquid in the cartridge. As we all know, as the liquid goes out there, the flavor's not as good, things of that nature. But because the atomizer and everything's kind of sucking it in, it will literally pull the polyfill right out of your cartridge and onto the atomizer. It's an easy fix. You just put the polyfill right back in there. That's another thing. How much do you fill up a cartridge? A lot of people have asked that. You do it to a pools all the way up to the top. Pools all the way up to the top, everybody, means all the way where you can almost see it, where it's going to overflow. That is the highest amount that you actually want to do on that cartridge. So that is a thing of how much do I actually fill it up on. A lot of us refill. Usually it's 2 to 3 drops. And again, as long as you would normally do a cigarette, I kind of compare it to lighting up a new cigarette. I just do my top off. All right. Last thing I do want to point out is if you are one of those people who have had a cartridge where you feel you have a metallic burnt taste, it's one of two things. One is you're not using, again, enough e-liquid. Enough liquid is going to the atomizer, and inside the atomizer, of course, it is drying out. The second thing is you overexhausted it. It didn't have the liquid, and you literally burnt it out. And unfortunately, the atomizer is pretty much done. There are some fix-its that you can try out there, but those are just some of the things to know. All right, everybody. This was a quick video, and it just kind of hit on some really weird things out there, but I had a lot of questions. I had a lot of people asking me over time, and I promised I'd make this video, and guess what? I made the video.
Sometimes I dance all night, sometimes I wouldn't dare.